Being the last of a dynasty, Domitian was post-mortally dunked on by his successors. His legacy is a doozy to untangle. Titus Flavius Domitianus was born on October 24th, 51 AD. Domitian found himself largely isolated from his immediate family after the age of 7, as Vespasian and big brother Titus were serving in the provinces. But an 18-year-old Flavian was chaotically reunited with them in 70 AD after trying his best to co-run a newly conquered Rome for about a year while Emperor Vespasian made his way from the east. Dad's arrival spelt the end for Domitian in truly prestigious positions. Sidelined under Titus's administration as well, he didn't exactly bewail his distant brother's death. On September 14th, 81 AD, Domitian began his reign. Inheriting a disaster-stricken empire, he concentrated power. Money was spent on 50 buildings, some new, some old. In the freshly expanded Colosseum, he would drop food onto the masses, and at theaters, like the brand new Odeon, he gave 300 sesterces to every attendee on 3 occasions. To finance these newfound popular pleasantries, Domitian taxed and instituted financial edicts, like an unsuccessful law banning the planting of new vineyards in Italia, which still really peeved the aristocracy, who were already rubbed the wrong way by Domitian's barefaced autocracy. Vespasian and Titus frequently listened to the Senate. Under Domitian, they fell on deaf ears. Things got worse for the upper class after a minor military uprising in 89 AD. Domitian began ordering treason-based executions a bit more liberally. An efficient despot he was, but the aristocracy wanted their power back. Superstitious Domitian openly feared dying at midday, so a palace conspirer lied to him, telling him it was the afternoon. With his guard down, Domitian was ambushed and slain after a struggle with 4 men on September 18th, 96 AD.